In this video, you're going to discover how to have a Northern Irish accent. If we're meeting for the first time, I'm Alistair from Belfast, the capital city of Northern Ireland. On this channel, you'll find all types of lessons, tips, and advice about English and accents. If you're new here, consider subscribing. If you're looking to improve your Northern Irish accent, please contact me. I'd love to help. My contact details are below in the YouTube description.
This is a map of the island of Ireland. It is made up of the 26 counties of the Republic of Ireland and 6 counties of Northern Ireland, which is part of the UK. Additionally, there are 4 provinces: Munster in the south, Connacht in the west, Leinster in the east, and Ulster in the north. We focus on the 9 counties of Ulster in this video, 6 in Northern Ireland and 3 in the Republic of Ireland. A typical Northern Irish accent is found in the 6 counties of Northern Ireland and in County Donegal. This one. That being the case, many locals say that if you simply walk to another street, you will find people speaking completely differently.
Now, to have any accent, you need to know how to pronounce certain sounds. Here's one important sound in the Northern Irish accent: the final plosive T sound at the end of words. Most British accents pronounce the T sound at the end of words. That, bat, flat. That bat lives in a flat. You can hear the T sound. That bat lives in a flat. In the Northern Irish accent, you lift your tongue to the roof of the mouth as if to make the T sound, but instead you flatten it out and don't actually make the T sound. That bat, flat. That bat lives in a flat. That bat lives in a flat. Listen to the difference. That bat lives in a flat. That bat lives in a flat. There are differences with other accents as well. Cockney, for example, where the mouth stays open and a long ah sound is made. The tongue is not lifted to the roof of the mouth. To improve in any accent, you must use the local language. Here are 3 examples. Gurn. This means to cry in Northern Ireland. Originally in Scottish, it was used to describe a person who was always complaining. So you can see the similarity. He's so pathetic, always gurning about everything. He needs to just grow up. A reminder that the ing sound in Northern Irish is pronounced as in, speaking, walking, and talking, rather than speaking, walking, and talking. You can find out more about this right up here in this video. Boggin. This translates as extremely dirty. Sammy, take your boots off before you come into the house. They're absolutely bogging. Another example of the in sound rather than the ing sound. A funny one I often remember my mum saying when I was a child, playing in the garden, perhaps rolling around in the mud. She would say filthy, dirty, bogging, black, which is kind of saying the same thing 4 times. She was advising me that I had to wash my hands before I came in and had dinner. Filthy, dirty, bogging, black. Mirror. This one is an absolute Northern Irish classic. The word mirror is pronounced differently across the whole English-speaking world. In Northern Ireland, we pronounce it with one syllable, mer. One syllable, mer. I'm not going to try and say it in any other accents. Sometimes what Northern Irish people say and what they actually mean are completely different. I'll break down 4 examples for you now. First, the tea is wet. This means that the tea is ready. Tea? The warm beverage, not tea, the meal. Number 2, I'm just going out to do the messages. No, this has nothing to do with post, letters, or text messages. It's about the shopping or the groceries. I'm just going out to do the messages. Number 3, no, I'll just stay for one, sure. Be careful here, this is never to be taken literally. The person who says this will likely stay in your house or the pub for many hours, probably until nearly bedtime. So you'll have them for a while, not just for one. Number 4, taps off. In clearer language, tops off. As in, it is warm enough outside to sunbathe. You know, that one day of the year when the thermometer finally hits 20 degrees. What's the crack? This is something I'm regularly asked about by people from all over the world. So what does it mean? It is absolutely one of the most important words we use in Northern Ireland. Everyone knows how to use it, but no one can really explain it. It's a catch-all word for fun, entertainment, news, gossip, banter, a laugh. It's definitely a word you should add to your vocabulary. And here are a few ways that you can use it. Number one, as a question, what's the crack or any crack? A superb way to start any conversation in Northern Ireland. Much better than the boring, how are you? It kind of means, how have you been? What's happening? How are things going? Something like this. Number two, to positively describe an event. See that concert last night? It was absolutely exhausting, but it was great crack. By the way, this video is part of my Northern Ireland series. There's a link to the playlist up here, and I'll also put one in the YouTube description below. Make sure to check it out after you've watched this video. Number three, before asking any question. Hey, what's the crack? You going to the cinema later? Doesn't really matter what the question is, it's just extra words. And number four, as an excuse. If you do something silly, and perhaps you're struggling to explain yourself, just for the crack is the best excuse available to you. Why did you spray paint your car bright pink? That'll cost hundreds to fix. Sure, why not? I did it just for the crack. To know more about the Northern Irish accent, watch one of these videos. There's one about Northern Irish words, one about Northern Irish phrases, and two that are similar to this one about how to do the Northern Irish accent. If you've enjoyed this video, remember to give it a thumbs up and share with your friends.